In the previous video, I showed you how to you can install XAMPP and WordPress in Windows 10. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can install another WordPress to your local host and start creating more websites. But first, if you are new to this channel, make sure to subscribe to get the latest reviews and tutorials for WordPress and other software. Let's get started. The first thing you need to do is go to your XAMPP folder. So this is my XAMPP folder. We need to run the XAMPP control so that we can be able to activate the Apache and MySQL to enable us to build your website. So go ahead and start Apache and also start MySQL. After you have successfully started them, go to your htdocs and create a new folder. We need to create a new folder. You can name it as you want. Let me name this one as a site 3. And after that, we go to WordPress, download WordPress if you have not downloaded yet. So because I've already downloaded, I just copy this one and go and paste it on my new folder. So this is my new folder. Let me just paste it there, and then I extract the files. Next, delete the zip file. And then open the folder and copy all the files here. Go back to your main folder, that is the folder you created, and paste them there. While we are copying this, let's go to our browser and create a database on our localhost. So just search for localhost phpMyAdmin, then create a new database. As we did in the previous tutorial, we are just going to do the same. So create a new database. Let's name the database site 3, just like the folder, and then click create. Now we are done with copying. Next thing we need to do is edit the wp-config sample file. So first, let's create a copy. And then rename it. Name the copy. Then we also need to edit this. So let's go to the first part, which is the database. So let's name it just as we name the database. So this one will be site 3, and then the username to root. Then delete the password here, and then save the file. Then go back, rename the file. Name this file and delete the last part. Then make sure you delete the folder, this WordPress folder. And then now we have successfully edited the configuration file. Let's go back to our browser, and now we need to search for localhost, then /site3. This page will pop up. We need to finish the WordPress installation, so click continue. Now you can name your website here. I just want to use a few of here. So let me just use Astro, and then the username I'll use Astro. Then here I'll just go ahead and use the same, and then confirm it is weak, then use the same email, and then discourage the search engine from indexing this site. Then click on install WordPress. The WordPress installation is done. So the next thing we need to do is log into our WordPress website. Use your username. I'll go ahead and use my username, which is Astro, and my password, and then click remember me, then click login. And we have successfully installed WordPress to our new site. So we can have as many sites as we want by installing different WordPresses, or we can create one multi-site using one WordPress installation. So In future videos, I'm going to show you how you can create more websites, and I have more websites here. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, then give us a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and turn on notification to get high quality reviews and tutorials on the best software and tools to help you build your online business. In the meantime, stay safe.